May 19th. Maybe you are the key to revival in your church. Leonard Ravenhill. Revival is the result of many factors: prayer, unity, preaching, surrender, to name a few. And above all, God's sovereign hand and timing. Most revivals have a person prominently associated with them, someone who becomes the face of that revival. However, revival is usually the result of someone laboring in prayer for many years, invisible and anonymous, preparing the way for God to come. Duncan Campbell was the face of the Hebrides revival, but Peggy and Ann Smith were the octogenarian sisters who paved the way in prayer. Evan Roberts was the face of the Welsh revival, but it was Seth Joshua who prayed that God would raise up someone from the mines to lead the revival. D.L. Moody was the famous preacher, but two anonymous women prayed for him to have the power of the Spirit. God is not just looking for pastors and preachers and evangelists to front the revivals He sends. He is also looking for those who will give themselves to labor in prayer for revival. There is a common saying to the effect that God is not looking for the able, but the available. He is looking for those who are available for whatever He wants us to do, whether it is to pray in the midnight hours or preach from a pulpit. Paul Scanlon speaks of how, while we are waiting for God to move, maybe He is waiting for us to move. Maybe God is saying, I'm waiting for your availability and surrender, your desire and desperation, your fasting and prayer, your early mornings and late nights, your heart, mind, body, and soul. There is an open door in heaven. Maybe we are the key. Today's prayer, Lord Jesus, I make myself available for your revival purposes. Use me as you will.